Okay, hello there, and I am outside to make it a bit different. I want to try to see if we can, if I can do it without editing with him. So they will not understand you.
Oi!
Of course.
Wow.
Oi!
No. I lost my thought. So, I want to talk about love. And we're not talking about love as human to human, but more like God life, God-like love, or I call it Buddha style. I like it. So, there will be, when you will be living like this, I guess, when you will be cleaning your mind, you will go through three stages of love. And I will assume that you kind of know what I'm talking about in general. I mean, the mirrors and other ideas, which I will be making videos as I go further. So the first stage is when you look at everyone as your mirror, as your reflection. And in spiritual world, you know about the mirrors, but this is pretty much literal, because you have a tool such as algoriswo or five dimension, and when you interact with people, you basically reveal something in your consciousness, and then you apply the technology to fix it. So people become exactly mirrors for you. Ooh, wah, wah. It was not strong like this. So you find the, you look at people as mirrors, and they are you. And at this stage already, you can see how easy it becomes to love people, because even people who annoy you horribly, such as Trump, as example, I'm sure some enjoy his presentation. So even that, you look at that person and you realize that this is you. It's you been obnoxious, it's you been rude, selfish, etc. You see exactly what it is, you fix it. You don't try to criticize and talk about how horrible that human is, because it's a waste. Why would you try to, I mean, what's the point of talking about reflection in the mirror? It's just a waste of energy. Instead, you ask yourself and you fix it in yourself, and then you see how it changes. It either person changes or it stops bothering you. So wherever it is, it either disappears, behavior or event, or your attitude towards it changes. Always. There is no third. So that is the second part, first stage, that everyone is your reflection. Second stage is when you... You look at people and you realize that obviously every person is a separate human being. You just kind of understand already that if you are driving your own life, then everyone else is doing the same. Because if they don't, then you are kicked back into first stage. Why don't they? And you start again. This is my reflection. What do I see? But in the second stage, when you see how other people live, and you already on the first stage, you stop trying to teach them something or correct them or whatever, because it's useless. It's your reflection. But on the second stage, you already, most of the time it's probably because you have cleaned enough already in yourself, so you look at other people and you are curious, oh interesting, like this person is doing something that it doesn't annoy me anymore, but it's kind of, you know, I notice it, which means it's still in my, I have a folder, it just doesn't have the corrupted data in it, speaking computer language. So you look at the person and you kind of, when you you kind of are curious already, because you know that this person is, yeah, like a driver, a co-driver next to you, and you are curious how it will change. And it changes, especially if you do some extra questioning yourself. That's how you solve situations or get something you want and not get, because you have obstacles in your consciousness. And the third stage will be when you already, it's not already that people are separate from you, they become your, how you call it in English, like continuity. We have some guests. They prolong you, sort of. So if you are a hand, another person will be a finger. And this is that kind of love when you feel, I mean, it's not that you feel like God, but this is how love, godly love feels, I guess, I understand. Because when you think about it, if you believe in God, God slash super consciousness slash whatever you call it, it's obvious that we, as humans, we have brain, which is dual. We think in duality. But wherever it is, bigger, it's not dual. It's a whole. Not a whole, it's my English pronunciation. The whole with WH. So it's not parts, good, bad, big, small. It's the whole. It contains both of each of the scale of anything. That's why when you apply technology, you use both sides. Because if you do just one, then it changes grotesquely to the opposite. True story. It's hilarious. So funny. So you got to apply to both, because we're still in our bodies, we're still dual. I lost my thought because I got interrupted with all the memories. So back to first stage, because that's when that's the thing, it's not that you've reached the top and stay there. It's always a circle, because the process is very interesting. It's not like you have cleaned it. It's always expanding. That's probably the word, because you kind of cleaned, you have situation or some kind of something and you work with it. And you cleared it out, you see the change, but then again, boom, something else on top. So it's always like you have a field, you clean it, but then it's like you zoom out, your field is bigger, you clean it, zoom out again as soon as you clean it. And it keeps expanding and expanding and expanding. So you kind of have your, kind of like in gaming, I guess, leveling, that's very much. So every time when you have expanded, you kind of begin from the first stage again. I mean, back and forth. And I wanted to make this short, but I forgot to mention, I think I didn't mention about egoism. When you begin this, you have to learn to love yourself. this is essential, because when we try, people learn love outside, and that's why we often we find people who understand us, who like us, who are good to us, and we, how you call it, hold onto them, because we are so empty inside. We don't love ourselves so much that we, first of all, we don't even realize it. And second, that we are so empty that we constantly search for something. That's why people desperately are scared to go, to leave. Bad relationship as example, or we are scared that we won't find what we think we have. But that's the thing, that if you are fulfilled inside within yourself by loving yourself, then you know that wherever you go, you are loved. And it's not love, you know how egoist people, I guess egoism is not good, because egoists get something at the expense of others. But it already contradicts, if you look at everyone as part of you, part of your world, part whichever reflection even at the beginning, then it's not egoism anymore, because why would I hurt another person if it's me? So it becomes exactly like this. You will not be an egoist if at the situation what to do something for yourself or do something for another person at your expense. Because I mean, that's the thing, when you are happy, and happiness comes from loving yourself as well. When you're happy, doing things for others is nothing. Greediness doesn't exist. Selfishness doesn't exist, because you know that whatever you want will happen if it doesn't, you know how to make it happen by digging, asking yourself, right? So you don't hold on to things anymore, thinking, oh, I will not share my food with someone because I love myself. No, you, I mean, like, I have food, someone is here, obviously I will share, because why would I want me to be hungry? This is very windy, my camera keeps falling down, so I have to redo, and I will have to edit. Ah, I didn't want to. Anyway, I wanted to, let's go back to the first stage, because this definitely will be, it will be met by you, for sure. What a weird language. At first, especially for others who are not in the theme with you, you probably will see like an egoist, bad friend, bad human, bad father, mother, whatever, you know, because people have expectations, aka filters, aka so they will try to apply it to you as well, especially if you were one person, then all of a sudden you started being different. It's gonna raise some eyebrows. obviously is my favorite word. One of, I have many which I keep repeating, like, so. So doing all of this, going this route, for sure, be prepared that people won't get you most of the time. I mean, people from the past, because you will just, I mean, in with science behind it, you will just stop resonating with them because everything will be different. This is one of the minuses to be covered, that your surroundings will change. But it will not matter because you will love them anyway. I sound like I don't know what. Yeah. And I don't care. Because, like, people say, my friend tells me, oh, you like everyone too easily. Like, I'm happy. I like people. Because people are me. What can I do about it? It's fun, you know? And if someone does something bad, like, okay, I'll clean it in my mind and go on. Like, it doesn't... It's like nothing. It means nothing. Nothing, really. Like, that's why it's fun. That's why no way me or anyone who lives like this is going back, because nothing can compare with this. And so what that people don't get? Me. Like, it doesn't matter. Because I love people. I have my moments when I still... that's when duality comes back. When it's my own darkness, my own dark side, my misanthrope that I used to be, wakes up. And then I just go back to stage one and clean it. Why do I want this, wherever it is? So that's... I feel that I didn't say everything I wanted because I get distracted constantly, but this should give some information for the first... I mean, for now. The idea that, yeah, you will... It's not egoism, because egoism is when you try to get what you want or benefit from something at the expense of others, most of the time. Because egoism, obviously, it's a lot of... But if everyone is you, your reflection or your part, or someone coexisting with you in second stage, then why? Why would you want something at the expense of others? Because you're hurting yourself, essentially. So, and that's how easy it becomes to love everything. We're not even talking just about people, but everything. When you think about big concepts, you just clear them in your mind, because it's all data. And then you move on, and the energy that you wasted on supporting your brain, right? Your body produces energy, which is wasted by supporting all of these neuron connections. Every time when people get upset or any kind of negativity, I don't like the word because it's duality. I'm kidding. But that's exactly, the brain is wasting energy by firing up those neuron connections. So if you clear that neuron connection, change it so that it's not wasting energy but producing it, as example, then you save energy. And that's why people like me, I feel high. Often, at my highest moments, I actually feel high, and I smoked weed and tried some interesting experimenting in my life, and it feels identical. When people say, you know, I mean, at moments when love, by the way, it's like this. It's so easy to fall in love. Everyone loves you. Everyone likes you. Everyone wants to be next to you because you are fulfilled. You love yourself, and people are, they just, They can't. That's what charisma is. Charisma is just a concept. I mean, it's what it is. It's actually this feeling of fulfillment when you are being yourself, when you're not pretending, not trying to do something, be someone, but to do something for other people to like you. But you just do whatever, you know, whatever thing you want to do without caring if you look stupid, if you look smart, if you, like, if it's good, if it's polite, whatever, you know. You do whatever and people feel it and they like you. Because, I mean, I had moments when people say, oh, you're so stupid. And I said, I laugh. Okay, I'm stupid, ha, ha, ha. And people laugh with me and they like me. Because, I mean, it's hilarious, but really, like, it's just like, okay, so what? It's easy, really. All you need to do is just look at everyone to begin with as your mirror. This is me. Yeah. And fix it. I'll probably go home and tell it. I want to do it today. That's it. Weird video and a lot of blah, blah talking from me because I get distracted, but this is it. I wish you a good day. Look how beautiful it is. This is the center of pandemic in Chicago. Anyway, it's like people everywhere. Nothing has happened. Yeah. Have a good one. Bye.